Hi guys, today we're playing Resident Evil Revelations 2. So, it can be a co-op game, but I got it for free. Episode 1 anyway. But if you do enjoy this, just let me know if you want more so I can buy the other episodes. Because might as well do this whole episode on here. On this one video. And I did do a thank you for 50 subscribers video, but I deleted it because I thought I could do better. And stupid. But yeah. Also, just wanted to say thank you for that. Oh my god. Count link code. What? Now I have played a little bit of it just to see what it's like. I haven't encountered any jump scares yet. I only got up to here and I thought I'd record. Watch out. Fucking get over here, I want to cut you up. I've got a knife. Give me the flashlight. God damn it. Go. I'll drop it on you. Halfway. Drop. That'd be super funny if you could just drop it. Did you enjoy?
I didn't stay the night.
Watch out.
Because I had to be back for work the following day. Most of the drive was on
road. I just know there's a jump scare coming. I just know it. I haven't even played past here and I just have that feeling. Oh my god!
I've been driving about 45 minutes and I was starting to get really tired.
Chop choppity chop chop chop. Oh yeah guys, I forgot to warn you. I'm sorry, but this will be a bit graphic. So if you don't like graphic stuff, click off this video, you've been warned.
My tiredness wasn't going away. I did something very questionable. I pulled over to the side of the road onto the grass behind the bushes to try and hide my car from anybody else who was going to come past. I made a mental note that the time was 11:22 and then I fell asleep. Some time later,
it's not lined up right. It needs to be lined up. I got some weed.
This time, it really freaked me out.
So now we can officially smoke weed every day. I'm joking.
Crossed my mind that it was just an animal inspecting my car, but why would it return almost an hour after it had left the previous time? I looked in my rearview mirror and just managed to catch a glimpse of something running away into the forest. I got the hell out of there. There was a bend. No more than 100 yards up the road, and as I came around it,
Jesus.
There was a car parked off to the side of the road with the driver's side door open. I slowed down just to look to see if
she said dead.
There wasn't.
Did you know her?
Then, I
She's dead now.
Mirror. I didn't see anything, and then all of a sudden, this guy comes sprinting around the corner. He starts screaming at me, shouting stuff like,
let's run down the stairs with a knife. That's worse than running with scissors.
I sped off. I never saw
the guy again. Chop chop. Help me out here. Oh god.
I once had to work at a very late shift at the funeral home to prepare a body for a viewing the following morning.
Great.
I think I finally
now he fell. Oh, well, that was easy. I smoked my weed. There we go.
20 dead people in the basement, especially when you hear constant noises.
We gotta be sneaky. Turn the fucking light off. Come on.
I'm in college, and I live on a campus in a dorm room.
Lucky I have a strong stomach.
In the last week,
stupid bitch.
We had all of our lights in our room, just our room.
She doesn't even slide down.
We've been trying to put maintenance requests in for the past week,
and now
but the website won't allow us to do it for some reason. Last night, I heard my roommate yelling from
the hallway
that her key wasn't working in the lock, and that she needed in now. So I stumbled out of bed. For the lock on the door.
Well, you suddenly a doctor now.
I saw her asleep in her bed. I backed away from the door to go back to the sleeping room, thinking that it had been a dream. I took a last
just
look
load his corpse. Sounds like a good idea.
Into my bed.
No teabag
him. When I saw the shadow under the door is a good inch or two.
Oh, come on. My controller's
so
being
down
stupid.
To see if there was someone standing at our door or the one across the hall. When I was eye level with the crack, I saw a pair of boots facing the door. Then, the person turned away, and I heard the stairwell door open. I couldn't even turn on the lights, because the bulbs were out. So I crawled into bed with my lamp, and sat there for an hour, because I was freaking out. To get onto the girl's floor, you have to have the student card of someone that lives here. They lock the building up at midnight every night, to make sure that only students guests are inside. We've had problems with homeless people sleeping in the basements of some of our buildings. I was freaking out because the boots at the door were men's boots. I could have.
I have no clue what I'm fucking doing.
I heard my roommate's voice. I took care of my mentally handicapped cousin a few years back. She could get around well enough, but due to severe arthritis in her knees and ankles, she had to be watched, helped into the bath, shit like that. I would go into her room in the morning, help her to her walker so she could go to the bathroom, and I would make her breakfast. One morning, I heard the water running in the bathroom when I went in to check on her. I had to pass her room.
I've no clue where the fuck we're going.
When I did, I saw that she was in a rocking chair in the corner. Her blanket.
I think we gotta go
her
back, cause we got the keys.
Back and forth. Don't leave the water on. You're going to flood the place. I went into the bathroom to shut the faucet off, and my cousin was there, washing her face. I immediately ran back to the room, but it was just her blanket crumpled up on the rocking chair. My cousin wanted to know why I undid her bed. I didn't stay too long after that. When I was younger, I used to live by the woods and could see a cemetery from my back porch. One Easter, I remember waking up.
I've no clue about what the hell we're doing.
I didn't tell
anyone,
but there was an extra Easter egg in my house that my parents didn't hide. Years later, when I was in high school, I asked my parents if they ever dressed up like the Easter Bunny and came into our room. They said they would never
go
through so much trouble.
We're now officially
sister,
squad.
Who I shared a bunk
no,
bed
we're a duo.
When this happened, and she remembers when the Easter Bunny came into our room. I was terrified that we both remembered seeing a person dressed as a bunny in our room. To make it even weirder, I told the friends I sat with at lunch what happened. One of the girls was my neighbor
across the
street.
She was opened
the
door.
She told me long time ago, she looked out her window during the night and saw the Easter Bunny standing in her driveway. It gave me chills. To this day, I am terrified of people who wear that costume.
This is Mankey. That's all I had to do.
I had awesome parents who let me sleep in the living room because my sister was a light sleeper and I could stay up until dawn.
Skilled.
But of course, I always ended up sleeping on the couch.
I like being this character. Oh, Jesus Christ.
One night, I wake up to a strange feeling, like an instinct. I just bolted into a sitting position and stared out the front window. We lived in rural Georgia, so you can imagine the magnitude of trees.
Nailed it.
In perfect light cast from the moon, I see a silhouette of someone in the tree in front of my house. The family dog and is snarling into the glass. Terrified, I run into my parents' room and try to explain to my parents that there is a strange person outside. My dad grabs something defensive. I tremble in my mom's arms until my dad comes back in and says that he saw no one and he wants me to go
Jeez,
to bed.
I'm taking my fucking time.
I decide to sleep in my regular bedroom. I tell my sister what happened. Dad is making regular rounds in the house with a cup of coffee. Everything is silent and calm.
No clue where I'm going.
Gives me a hush signal and runs away. He just turns around to run a straight line away.
This game actually reminds me of Amy. Oh shit. Cut your ass up.
Every bit of this
Don't fuck with me, bro.
True.
I'm gonna stab you. Gotcha.
Going out of town for the weekend.
Alright, let's go. Completely just did nothing.
Early 20s, not a tight budget, so we decided to carpool.
My fucking god, how many of them are there?
We even found
they're not even jump scaring me anymore.
Bert, to ride along with
but they're being a pain in the ass.
I had only met Bert once prior. He was a huge redneck with a wandering eye. Intimidating and drunk might be the best words to describe him. On the 3-hour ride to the tournament, Bert was already
Come on.
Talking crazy
oh, for fuck's sake.
About his wife. Apparently,
Come on, you stupid
they
bitch.
Were going through a divorce, and he was not happy about it. He eventually starts describing this fight, where he has her on the floor with his foot on her neck.
Alright, there we go.
Her throat. Everyone in the vehicle was like, what the hell is wrong with this guy? We all make it back home from the tournament, and the following Monday, I get a call. It's the cops. Holy shit. They asked me the strangest questions. About
Holy shit, I nailed that.
Did he have mud on his shoes? Did he mention
yes.
his wife? What was his demeanor like on the trip? Weeks later, I would find out what really happened. Bert murdered his
wife hell yeah.
that Thursday night. The next afternoon, he gets in my car for a road trip. That fight that he described in the car wasn't just some fight. He was describing how he murdered her. I went on a road trip and shared a hotel room with this guy. I had a very frightening night last year. Out of the blue,
fucking hate flashlight, do you?
I
got Topaz.
I grabbed my phone and looked at the screen, and it was a private number.
Crowbar.
I went back to sleep and thought nothing of it. I woke up again a couple hours later, and I looked on my phone.
Oh, nice. I don't have to put
the
fucking thing away.
15 more times. That was an enough to wake me up completely.
I knew that it would contain something.
New voicemails from that number. I listened to the first one that was left. A man whispered into the phone, "I just crawled through the window in your dining room." That obviously made my hair stand on end, and I felt like I was going to pass out. I sat in bed, terrified, for a few minutes, thinking of what I should do next. I listened to the second voicemail. The man then said into the phone,
"I'll shine that in your face." Good damn.
Locked. After hearing that, I immediately called 911. I told them somebody was in my house. They proceeded with questions, and I didn't hear a single one.
Bitch, I wanted the shotgun.
I stayed on the phone with them until two
stupid bitch
showed up at my house, and they searched the place. Eventually, I felt comfortable enough to let them leave, and when they did,
she's raging.
The third voicemail. The man whispered into the phone, "I am hiding in your house." After hearing that, I got in my car and drove to my sister's house and slept there that night. I didn't return home until the next day. More police officers, my sister, and her husband. The whole place was searched.
She's always the one opening doors. Come here, mate, I've got a shotgun for you.
Not a single
phone. How does everyone do that?
Night, and I need to tell myself, it was just some kid trying to scare me.
Shit, this kind of reminds me of Outlast.
When I was in high school, you could say I had some mental issues. I'm not going to go into too much detail, but I was depressed all the time and thought about killing myself regularly. My parents had me go off to a psychiatric institution for boys. I made friends with boys who were like me. They had similar problems and understood where I was coming
from. Hey, let's read off our palms.
A new boy arrived on our block. We all knew very quickly that he was a very special case. On his
Shit.
First day, he attacked another boy with a plastic spoon he had broken. He was put into private isolation,
Fuck.
Where he received counseling every day.
Great, we need to find the control ring.
To try to keep him calm. At some point, he was Stop. Free to be around Pass. The rest of the boys again. And on the day he was first allowed to join us, he came up behind me when I was drawing and bit the back of my neck. I don't mean he gave me a nibble. I was rushed to the nurse's station and had to get 23 stitches. I was released from the institution before this boy
Such
was,
a bitch.
And every day I was there with him, I was terrified. He would look at me often with a hatred in his eyes.
Maybe the fuck
All he wanted
not.
To do was hurt me and every other boy there. I have no idea what became of him.
Wake up, mate.
My father remarried.
I'm waking up with mutants.
My new stepmother had three kids.
Good morning, mutants.
A boy who was just a baby.
Stuff this, I'm out.
Was also a boy, and he was a very nice kid. He was 2 years older than me. Her middle child was my age, and she was a girl. This girl, we'll call her Amy. Was extremely troubled. She was a very, very mean child. When we first moved in with them, I would wake up in the middle of the night, and Amy would sometimes be there, in the doorway to my room, watching me. I'm not exaggerating. She actually did this, and my dad flipped out when I told him. Amy stopped doing it after she got in trouble, but after a few weeks, one night, I woke up
Fuck.
To unbelievable pain. Amy had pushed a thumbtack
fucking bear
into
on.
My forehead. I screamed and cried, and my dad and Amy's mom came running into the room. Amy got in trouble, of course. but not like she should have. My parents
Don't
were in
touch her
denial
legs.
and figured she was just mad at
Okay.
me. But I told them there was something wrong with her and that nothing had happened and she had no reason to be mad at me and to do something like this. I could tell that my dad knew there was something more that was wrong. I tried telling my dad. I thought she should go to a hospital, but at my age, I didn't really know what they were called. Just a hospital for people with problems. We lived down a dirt road, and during the weekends, sometimes I was forced to play with Amy. I constantly told her to stop staring at me and to not come near
Fucking
me.
books.
I was living in
Okay.
hell. This little girl was crazy. All she talked about was becoming a doctor so she could do surgery, but maybe not good surgery, as she put it. She said it would be fun to cut people's bodies open and fill their cavities and arteries with broken glass and nails. To say I was scared of her would be an understatement. One day, I was playing in my
Really?
room when she told me to come with her. She wanted to show me something. I followed her down to the creek by our house, and when I got there, I almost fainted.
Nice.
She had brutally killed a bunch of ducks. I ran home and cried. She told me that if I told anybody,
Celebration smack.
she'd stick thumbtacks into my head again. My dad and her mom eventually got divorced a couple years later, and it's been many years now. About 5 years ago, I saw on her mom's social media account that she was committed to a mental institution.
Thanks for
Surprise,
nothing.
surprise. I was asked to house sit a few years back for my good friend Paul. He and his family were going to Disney World on vacation for 5 days, and he wanted me to stay there and feed their pets. Just make sure everything was cool while they were gone. I was unemployed, and he
Yeah,
offered me
does shit me
$200.
too.
I really needed the money, so I agreed to do it. The first couple of days were fine, fun, and relaxing, as a matter of fact. They had a hot tub that I took advantage of, and their two dogs were really awesome. On my third night there, however, things started to get weird. I made a sandwich for dinner and left everything on the counter. Or so I thought. About
Dear
an
Mama,
hour
I
later,
don't
I
know if
returned
you'll get
to
to
the
read
counter
this,
to grab a beer and put everything away,
but I need
and I
you.
noticed the bread was
They
already
call
lit
us
up.
experiments,
The
they
mustard
torture us
canning
every
bubbles,
day.
though already back in
Every
proof,
day, what did
stuck in
I
the
do to
positive
deserve
bag
this?
to put
Why is this
everything away,
happening? It hurts so
but I was
bad. Every
pretty
day I'm
sure
scared
I brushed it
of
off
what will happen
and fell asleep
next.
watching TV. The
Mama,
next day I
please
woke
help!
up and the TV was off. Not just the
Oh
TV
God.
though, all the lights in the room, the
That's
TV, and
depressing.
the speakers too. I was officially weirded out by this point and thought they might have had a ghost or something. Again, I brushed it
Oh,
off.
fuck me.
The rest of the day, everything was cool.
Just sit here and
Nothing
watch.
weird happened. Then, the
Jesus
next day,
Christ.
I went to the store, and when I came back, I decided to get back in the hot tub. A while later, I got out and realized my towel that I had left hanging on the hook on the deck was gone. I went inside, dripping all over the place, and found my towel in the master bathroom, flung over the side of the shower. I knew for sure I should not put the towel there. And I called Paul to ask him if he was used to weird
More
shit
an
like
art,
this happening
standing
in his
enemy,
house,
and
and
Claire
if they might have
for
heard
the
ghosts.
physical attack
Told me
in the
no,
main
that they hadn't
campaign.
experienced
Oh my
anything
god.
weird. He then told me to ask John. I asked who John was, and his answer confused me. He said it was his
This game's
brother-in-law.
terrifying.
I told him his brother-in-law
Oh
had found
Jesus, she
him
just
by
kicked him in the
sniper
face.
there.
Holy,
His response
holy
gave me
cow.
goosebumps. He said
Oh,
John
fuck
lives
off.
there with us. I was so freaked out that I tuned out everything else he said to me and finally said
Jesus,
back
I just
to him,
shot her in the back.
I have not seen him one time.
Alright
Why would
guys,
he
I hope
ask
you
me to
enjoyed
help
this
him if
video.
he
Oh
lives
my
in
fucking
New
god,
York?
is this immortal or
He then said
something?
John was disabled and he couldn't drive a car or get
But
around town
anyway,
easily. After hearing that,
Make sure you
I
like,
told
share,
him, yeah,
comment, and
I haven't
subscribe,
seen
and
him
I'll
in
see you in the next
months
video.
and that I was
And
so
thank you
freaked
very
out.
much for
I was
50 subs,
relieved.
or oh
He
god,
tried to
49
talk
now,
with
but
me,
thank you for
but I
50
hung up
anyway.
and ran to start
Alright
gathering
guys,
my clothes and whatnot.
bye.